Few things are as big a headache for beekeepers of all levels of experience as finding a queen in your honeybee colony. Sometimes it feels like finding a needle in a haystack. How do you find that one bee when there's 10, 20, 30,000 other bees in the nest all vying for your attention through their movement? Well, unfortunately, there's no foolproof way to find a queen in a honeybee colony. There's just some tricks that I can tell you. And as you gain experience, you'll get better and better at it. But guess what? Even old timers like me sometimes find it difficult to find a queen, especially depending on the size of that hive, the strength of the colony that's living in it, etc. So I'll give you a few pointers that help us here at the lab, that have helped me in the past, that I hope will help you as you try to perform that task of finding a honeybee queen. Pointer number one. Buy marked queens. Nothing screams at you as loud as a queen with a dot on her thorax. That makes her incredibly easy to find. Now, I realize it can be difficult for beekeepers to grab the queen, perfectly put that dot on her back, and return her to the nest. Maybe you're not comfortable doing that. Well, if you're purchasing mated queens, one of the add-ons that you can get to that purchase is you can have the queen breeder paint that queen's back before they put them in the cage to mail them to you. So I always recommend purchasing queens that are already marked. But if you've already got an unmarked queen in the nest, maybe your colony made one on its own, or it's too late, you've installed an unmarked queen, there's a few things that you can do to increase your chances of finding the queen. So I'll talk a little bit about nest configuration as the first pointer in that regard. If you think about it, generally speaking, bees put their resource combs on the outside of the nest. So you're looking at the side of this honeybee hive, which means frames 1, the one closest to me, and 10, the one furthest from me, are the ones most likely to be mainly honey and pollen. So this is an overgeneralization, but in general, queens don't hang out on resource frames because they're looking for empty cells in which they can lay. So those cells tend to be where there's already brood. Now again, the queen can be anywhere in this hive, but if you're increasing your probability of finding her, you're going to look on frames that already have brood. Now, what types of brood frames would be the ones that you target? Well, there's a little strategy there as well. And again, this is an overgeneralization. You can find queens anywhere in the hive, but in general, queens are going to be on the brood frames that contain the greatest number of open or uncapped cells. Remember, queens are looking for open cells to put their head into, to determine that there's nothing in there, to back their abdomen into so that they can lay an egg. So if you've got a frame that's full of capped brood, there's a lower probability that the queen will be there than if you've got a frame that's full of open cells, or those cells contain many eggs or lots of very young larvae. In fact, that's one of the things I look for. When I'm moving through this hive and not finding the queen, I think to myself, well, if I've got a frame that's mainly eggs or a frame that's mainly young larvae, then she's most likely to be there. Again, I'll say this throughout this video, the queen can be anywhere in the nest. I'm just talking about ways to increase your odds. Focus on brood frames. Not just brood frames, but frames that have eggs and young larvae, or frames that are completely empty in the middle of that brood nest. Some years ago, I read an article where a group of individuals compared multiple ways of scanning the comb to look for the queen. And to boil it all down, they found that the zigzag pattern works best. So when you pull a comb, you start in the top left corner and you go across. Then you go down just a little bit and go across and across. And so you're zigzagging back and forth across the face of that comb. Now, I never look at a side of a frame just once. I'll look at side A, look at side B, look at side A, look at side B. And if I've gone through it two times, then I'll return that frame to the nest and go throughout the rest of the box. Now, there may be times where you absolutely must find the queen, in which case you can't give up until you've found her. So you'll pull the first frame, you'll look for her there. If she's not there, you'll sit it outside the nest, and then you'll go frame by frame. I will usually go through a hive's frames twice before I take the next approach, which is if she's not on a frame, she's probably on a lid or a queen excluder or on the walls or the bottom board of the box. So if I've gone through the frames twice, away from me and back to me, then I will sit those frames out of the nest as I look for her. And once this box is empty, I will look at the walls of the box and the bottom board of this box to see if she is there. And if there's ever clusters of bees, I might use my hive tool and my finger to move those clusters of bees around to see if she's there. Now, I will warn you, anytime you take a frame out of the hive, it's possible that you've missed the queen. So if you take that frame and lean it up against a stack of supers maybe that you have on the ground, or another box, or the hive that's right next to it, you run the risk of the queen leaving that frame and going to another hive, to another box. If you lay it on the ground, resting up against the hive that you're working, she might come off the frame and go up under the box. So if I must find a queen, and I fail to find her, I will keep looking two or three passes through the combs. I'll look on the walls and the bottom board of the hive. If I don't find her then, I put everything back together, go work other colonies in the apiary, and then I come back to this hive. If I've done that twice, look through it the first time, couldn't find her, work other colonies, come back to this hive, look through it, can't find her, I'll come back another day just to confirm. Now you have to remember, anytime you don't have an excluder on your hive, like this one here, the queen can be absolutely anywhere. So I always flip over the lid and just confirm that she's not on the lid. And I'm going to follow that zigzag pattern across the lid. Don't see her here. I'm relatively comfortable sitting this lid at the entrance of the hive. I lean it up against the entrance of the hive so that if she's on there, she might move back into the nest. Then I think to myself, what's the orientation of the nest? This comb is likely to be honey and pollen. This comb is likely to be honey and pollen, depending on how whoever worked this hive before me has moved frames around. I typically prefer to pull the second frame, so I will usually start there, and if I don't see her there, I will go throughout the nest, going frame after frame until I find her. So I always remove that second frame first, gently lift that frame, and then I'll sometimes rest the comb here, and then I'll use that zigzag pattern across the face of this comb looking for the queen. I will point out a few things here. First, there's some cap brood, a lot of pollen, and most of the brood on this frame happens to be older, so it's less likely that she'll be here. One of the tricky things about finding queens is combs can often have a lot of contour. They can also have cracks and nooks and crannies, and if you get multiple layers of comb built on the same frame, it can be really great places for queens to hide. I'm resting this frame on these other frames to be able to hold this frame steady to show you, the viewers, what I'm looking at, but this is a very dangerous way to get that queen lost. Say, for example, she's on the other side of this frame. The sheer act of me touching this frame to these other frames means that she can leave this frame and go to other frames. It's not such a big problem here because I'm working my way that way, but as I've made sure she's not on frames and moved those frames this way, I could end up putting the queen who was on a later frame onto an earlier frame, so I'm really careful about that. But at this point, I don't see her here, so I'm going to flip this frame to check and see if she's on the other side. If I ever see clusters of bees like I do here, I might use my hive tool or finger to brush them out of the way just to make sure that she's not present. I don't see her on this side. I always flip it back to the other side. I don't see her here. I'll make one more pass on that second side. I don't see her here. And I like to leave combs out of the nest when I work, so I'll leave this particular comb out. And now I'll start with the first frame and go that way through the nest, quickly looking for the queen. Ah, as expected, this is completely a resource frame. Honey in the corners, pollen in the center. It's very conceivably possible the queen is on this frame, but it's simply less likely that she is. I don't see her on either side. I'll flip back. I don't see her there. I'll flip and don't see her here. And then I will progress through the nest. Oftentimes, if I ever have this first frame out and the second frame out, I might lean over just to check the inside wall that's nearest me. I don't see her there. And so now I'm going to progress through the remaining frames in this hive. This is primarily a capped brood frame, and the rest of the cells have resources, specifically pollen and honey. Again, as I've said now many, many times, she can technically be here, it's just less likely for her to be here. And then you'll see at the bottom of this frame, bees start clustering. If I ever see that, I'll turn it up just to make sure that I don't see the queen on the bottom of the frame. Honestly, hunting for queens just gets easier over time as you learn to recognize their body, their movement, where they're likely to be. It's just something that will become second nature. I found her on the way up on this frame. Here she is, walking around. Notice she's close to the crack. If I wasn't paying attention, she could easily go through that opening on the side of the frame, but there she is. Now that I've seen her, I know I have her, and I can make whatever management decision is necessary at this point. Now I want to remind you, you could have done all of these things and not found the queen. Well, what may be the reason for that? Well, if you've got stacks of supers on a hive, maybe she's up in the other supers. If you've got an excluder and convince yourself, no, she's in this bottom box. Well, queens can sometimes get through excluders. But there's often the most obvious thing that you're overlooking if you've searched multiple times and can't find her. It's possible they're just queenless. So what I do to confirm that is I look for eggs or very young larvae. If I don't see those, or if I don't see those and I see queen cells, that's an indication that they're queenless. But even if you see eggs and young larvae, they can still be queenless within the last day or two. So I might put everything back together and check a few days from now. Finding queens is no perfect science. Even the best of us get stumped every once in a while. But follow these tricks to increase your odds of finding that queen to reduce the chances that she's just the needle in a haystack.